Welcome to UroChannel and another video from my PRP series. PRP means platelet rich plasma and is derived from the patient's own blood. The idea is that platelets are concentrated through centrifugation and re-injected into the site of the body that needs treatment to initiate healing and tissue regeneration. For this video, I have searched the literature regarding effects of PRP in Peyronie's disease. My name is Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Peyronie's disease is not a new topic on UroChannel. There is a whole playlist of videos dealing with the nature of the disease and how to treat it the non-surgical way. I will link it at the end. So, PRP has been around in medicine for a number of years now, but for urology, it's a brand new thing. This means that we have some small pilot and feasibility studies on PRP injections into penile plaques, but for the time being, we don't have enough data to recommend it as standard therapy. I think we can say that it is feasible and that it is safe, because it doesn't involve any pharmaceutical agents. It's the patient's own blood, and up to now, there are some reports on decreasing curvatures after some months in follow-up. But even if I think the results look promising and maybe it'll develop into some kind of approved therapy, I am skeptical towards monotherapy in Peyronie's disease, and I think I have some backup from the literature for that opinion. Given the fact that no standalone therapy hitherto has been able to do the trick, one should be cautious not to overestimate the therapeutic potential of PRP. In my opinion, non-surgical therapeutic strategies aiming at fighting erectile pain, putting an end to inflammation, and ameliorate curvature must be some sort of combination therapy with systemic medicines, local injections into the plaque, and/or shockwaves, and some kind of mechanic traction. From animal studies, we know that PRP likely induces positive changes in the affected areas. In a study from 2019, 20 rats were divided into 4 groups and 3 groups received some kind of PRP injection. Compared to the control group, which just received saline injections, the researchers noted significant positive changes for fibrosis, collagen smooth muscle ratio, and type 3, type 1 collagen ratio. Already in 2017, a rather large series of 90 consecutive patients with Peyronie's disease were enrolled into a trial with a combination of PRP and hyaluronic acid. 28 of them had calcified plaques. Variability of curvature was high. 13% had an angulation below 30 degrees, and 13% had an angulation over 59 degrees. They received PRP injections into the plaque 5 times every 15 days. The first evaluation took place after 3 months. At the final control, mean improvement was 16.5 degrees plus minus 10.5 degrees. This represents a mean improvement of 39.7% plus minus 24.8%. Calcified plaques didn't change the outcome. Then there is a study from Morocco published in 2023 looking at PRP only. 65 consecutive patients with PD and angulation between 25 degrees and 45 degrees were divided into 2 groups according to their deviation angle. In this study, they did something very smart. Before they started, they checked for platelets in the PRP and found out that they had to experiment with the right amount of spin of the centrifuge first because platelets were destroyed with too much spin. This point refers back to my first video on the topic where I talk about the pitfalls surrounding PRP production. If you haven't watched it, check it out because it will help you to understand the difficulties with the method. The patients in the study received injections every 15 days for 2 months and then at 3, 6 and 9 months. Apart from mild pain and occasional superficial hematoma, the treatment was well tolerated. After 9 months, there was a reduction in angulation of 16.9 degrees in group 1 and 17.3 degrees in group 2. Additionally, the researchers noted a remarkable improvement of erectile function, with the scores of the International Index of Erectile Function improving by 50% in group 1 and 61% in group 2. Penis size increased by 8.1% in group 1 and 7.9% in group 2. All of this sounds encouraging, also keeping in mind that no traction therapy was performed, just PRP injections. But there are still many unanswered questions. If we just skip the usual, no control groups, no randomization, etc., which is not so important at this stage, I think there should be more focus on patient selection. The studies looked at heterogeneous groups. When we look at Peyronie's disease, there is an initial inflammatory phase followed by a stable phase. None of the studies accounted for that because the outcome may be different if injecting PRP into an inflammatory active area. Apart from that, not all nodules or plaques, as we call them, are equal. There are calcified plaques and there are non-calcified plaques. In my opinion, calcified plaques are very resistant to any kind of treatment. This was also seen in the IMPRESS 1 and 2 trials on collagenase injections. Patients with calcifications didn't improve much. The first study I mentioned in this video looked into this and didn't find a difference. And some of the patients with calcified plaques had some impressive changes on ultrasound. So there's still a lot to discover with PRP and Peyronie's disease. The guidelines recommend against using it outside of clinical trials, which is reasonable because one has to make sure first that it is effective and could be recommended as a serious treatment option. However, patients with Peyronie's disease need help now, not in 10 or 20 years. PRP is feasible and obviously has a very low complication rate. So I don't think it is wrong to give it a try if it is clear that this is off-label treatment and that for the time being, we can't really predict its efficacy. Because the damage has already been done. One can't really make it worse. And in severe curvature, there would be surgery anyway at some point in time. So why not try it and avoid surgery at best? Here are the playlists on PRP and Peyronie's disease. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.